Welcome to the last video on the series of Boiler of Module 2, Subject Basic Mechanical Engineering. In this video, we are going to learn about construction and working of Babcock and Wilcox water tube boiler and boiler accessories. Let's have a recap. In the previous video, we learned about the working and construction of Lancashire boiler and boiler mountings. There are other varieties of what you call boilers are also there. Locomotive boiler is there and marine boiler is there. All these boilers are belong to the same category of fire tube, but their construction feature differs depending upon the requirement. So in this video, we are going to learn about the working and construction of Babcock and Wilcox boiler. Basically, a Babcock and Wilcox boiler is a horizontal, externally fired, naturally circulated, stationary water tube boiler. When we want to study the boilers, we need to know about its construction, we need to know about how the flue gases move in it and how the water is circulated. This is true for any kind of boiler. In construction, we have to look at what is the position of the cell, how the brickwork supports the boiler and what type of combustion is taking place in it. As far as flue gases is concerned, direction of gases we need to know, and we need to know that what method of deflection is used to supply the gas. And in water circulation, we should know that how the water enters the boiler and what type of heating method it takes place and what quality of steam is produced. This is true for any type of the boiler. Let's look these things in Babcock and Wilcox boiler. As we know, the Babcock and Wilcox boiler is a water tube boiler. So basically, it has got a drum which is suspended from the above. But the brickwork will only support, or it encloses the furnaces, which will help in movement of the flue gases from combustion chamber to the chimney. So here we are using externally fired combustion system. There you can see that one, there is a chain grate combustion system is utilized here. And the coal is supplied through the hopper. And the burning is taking place externally. The flue gases which are generated from the combustion of the flue, they will move upwards with the help of the deflector, which is constructed with the help of a brick. These all flue gases, they move upwards. When they move upwards, they pass through the water tubes in which the water is flowing. Thus, they heat the water in the tubes to generate the heat. After that, the hot gases will move into the downward section of the boiler, and again they move upward section of the boiler with the help of what we call as a baffles. These baffles will help to control the direction of the flue gases. Once the flue gases pass through all these areas, then they go to the chimney. This is the direction, or this is the path the flue gases takes place in the Babcock and Wilcox. If you look at the water circulation, the water which is there fed into the boiler from the front end, it goes to the backwards, and from there it enters the downward, or what we call it as a inlet header. The inlet header is a section where inclined water tubes are connected here. The water comes to the downtank header first, and later it slowly moves upwards towards the uptake header. So we know when the water is get heated up, its density is going to become less. Because of the less density, the water starts moving upwards. The cold water comes from the boiler, and the hot water or the steam starts rising into the boiler through uptake header. So because of this difference in density of the water, which takes place because of the difference in the temperature. So this phenomena we call it as a thermosiphoning. So with the help of this of thermosiphoning, water is circulated in Babcock and Wilcox boilers. So in this way, the steam is generated. So normally the steam which is generated, which will be accumulated at the top portion of the water and steam drum here. So in Babcock and Wilcox, we have super heater connected to here. So this super heater takes the wet heat, wet steam from the boiler, and it is reheated to produce the superheated steam. The superheated steam is supplied to the device through the steam stop valve. So this is all about the working of Babcock and Wilcox boiler. For more details, I request you to go to the link which is shown below here. Kindly watch this video and come back to my video. I hope you have watched that video carefully. Let's answer some questions on that. It is, what is the function of header? Why buffers are provided? The thermosiphon effect helps in what purpose, which is related to the water? Write your answer in a chat. Hope you have written the answers. So basically, the function of header is to connect the water tube boilers with the drum. These are the temporary storages which are connected at the inlet and outlet of the water tubes. Downtake header collects the water and uptake header supplies the hot water to the boiler. The buffers are the one which control the direction of the flue gases. So thermosiphon effect helps in circulation of the water. I hope that one you got all answers correct. Before we understand what you mean by the boiler SSCs, look at an example of a bike. Normally we have bike, and along with bike we have certain accessories such as buzzer, grip covers, ladies handle, seat cover, sari guard, brake pedal rubber. So these are the things which are provided to the bike for the better performance of that. So without that also we can run the what you call bike. Even we may have a lock for locking the helmet. So all these devices which enhance the performance of the bike, we call them as accessories, which are not essential, but definitely they improve the performance of the bike. Similarly, boiler also has got certain boiler accessories which will help in improving the efficiency of the boiler, and which will help you in performing the boiler in a much better way. Here is the list of boiler accessories. First one is economizer or feed water heater. The second one is air preheater. The third one is super heater, and the fourth one is feed water pump. These all boiler accessories are not integral part of the boiler. Normally these boiler accessories are fitted outside the boiler. The diagram below shows the different positions of the accessories which are placed along with the boiler. Let's study one by one. So let's consider the economizer or the feed water heater. Normally we found that one, the flue gases after heating the water or converting the water into the steam, they move towards the chimney. But still they have certain potential in them. It means some heat quantity is hidden in these flue gases which are moving towards the chimney. So to recover the heat from these flue gases, we make use of feed water heat. The water enters the feed water and get heated with the help of flue gases, and the preheated water enters the boiler. In this way, the economizer or the feed water heater recovers the heat energy which is left out in the flue gases. Normally, this economizer is fitted in the path of flue gases which are moving towards the chimney. Let's look at where this is situated. This is situated next to the what they call superheater. Let's consider another boiler accessory, that is air preheater. As the name indicates, it heats the air. Preheater heats the air which is being supplied for the combustion purpose. This device also consists of tubes wherein the flue gases will pass through that one, and air which is from the atmosphere, it is sucked into the air preheater and it is passed through these tubes. When the air passes through these flue tubes, it is get heated up. In this way, the pre-air heater increases the efficiency of the boiler. It provides better condition for the combustion purposes. It consumes less heat energy to produce the steam. Normally, this particular air preheater is situated between the economizer and the chimney. In this way, the boiler accessory help in consuming the less energy. It means with less quantity of the coal or liquid fuel or gaseous fuel, we will able to produce more heat. The next boiler accessory is what we call it as a superheater. We know there are certain situations where we need to have the superheated steam rather than wet steam. To convert the wet steam into superheated steam, this particular device is used. This particular device consists of a U-tube. One end of is connected to the wet steam, the another end is connected to the supply to the device. The hot flue gases which are coming out of the boiler, which are moving towards the chimney, first they are passed through three superheater. This superheater uses the heat still available in the flue gases to convert wet steam into the superheated steam. Let's see that one where this superheated steam is situated. If you look at the diagram, the gases which are coming out of the boiler, the first they pass through the superheater, where they lose some amount of heat they are carrying in the superheater. Later they move to the economizer, still there some more heat is removed from there. Afterward they move to the preheater, again the heat which is there in the flue gas is recovered. In this way, with the help of boiler accessories, we can utilize the complete heat energy which is being possessed by the flue gases, which increases the performance of the boiler. In this way, the boiler accessories are the devices which are attached to the increase efficiency and overall performance of boiler or the boiler plant. Just have a glance at the differences between boiler mountings and boiler accessories. Mountings are meant for the safety purpose. Accessories are for the increasing the efficiency. Mountings are integral part of the boiler, whereas accessories are not integral part of the boiler. Boiler cannot work without mountings. Boiler can work without accessories. So in this way, we learned about the boilers, that is definition of the boiler, function of the boiler, classification of the boiler, construction, working principle, application of Lancashire boiler, Babcock-Wilcox boiler, boiler mountings and accessories. With this, the chapter on boilers is concluded. Thank you.